Sergeant Preston of the Northwest Mounted Police with Yukon King, swiftest and strongest lead dog breaking the trail in the relentless pursuit of lawbreakers in the wild days of the Yukon. Back to the days of the gold rush as Sergeant Preston with his wonder dog Yukon King meets the challenge of the Yukon. This is the Yukon, the territory patrolled by Sergeant Preston. A wilderness of mountains, forest, and untamed rivers, dotted with widely scattered settlements along its newly beaten trails to sudden wealth. Whitehorse, the Yukon's southern terminus of the main winter route to the Klondike goldfields from Skagway. When winter came with its days only 3 to 4 hours long, time was a thing to be forgotten. It made little difference to a man's business or pleasure whether it was 3 in the afternoon or 3 in the morning. It was the job of the Northwest Mounted Police, men like Sergeant Preston, to keep the peace under these strange conditions.
Crunchy. Well, how's everything at the Barney Considine place since he's been away, Martin?
Just fine, Sergeant. Being business manager for a millionaire sure beats scratching for a living.
I hear he's inspecting some of his property up near Dawson. When do you expect him back?
Oh, a month, maybe two. You know how Mr. Constantine is.
Yes, I do. His daughter must be very lonely.
Luann? She's got Mrs. Carp, a housekeeper, for company. Besides, she's pretty busy taking care of her father's affairs while he's away. You know, Luann's got a level head on her shoulders for a 22-year-old. Fact is, I just dropped her off at the hotel for a business conference.
Business conference?
Yeah, that's right. Some man from the States. Gathered it had something to do with the boss's private jewel collection.
You happen to know this man's name?
Talon. Gregor Talon.
Talon, huh? We received a telegram from the authorities in Skagway requesting we check on Mr. Talon. Pick him up for questioning.
Interesting. For what reason, if you don't mind telling me?
No, as a matter of fact, I think you should know. Talon is a notorious jewel thief. He's suspected of stealing a fabulous black pearl known as the Eye of Evil. Too well known in the States to be sold there.
Say, I'll bet he's trying to palm it off on Luann. I'd better warn her at once.
Hold it, Martin. Better let me handle this. Where did you say the girl was meeting Tullen?
A hotel cafe. Out of curiosity, how much is this Eye Evil worth?
Well, I've been told it's been appraised for more than $100,000. Come on, King.
Mr. Talon, I think we had better wait until my father returns from Dawson.
Oh, be sensible, Miss Constantine. I'm a busy man. I can't wait around for your father's return. You told me yourself it might be a month or more.
Well, I don't like to be rushed on matters like this.
You have nothing to worry about. You've seen my credentials and the pearl.
Well, there's no question about the pearl being genuine, Mr. Talon.
What is it then?
Well, frankly, you refuse to disclose the name of the legal owner of the pearl.
As I've already told you, my client doesn't wish it known that he's in financial straits and has to sell. That's why they sent me way up here.
But yet you expect me to obligate my father without the owner's confirmation? Well, you're expecting a bit too much, Mr. Talon.
I'm not obliged to swallow insults, miss. Perhaps I better seek a market for the gem elsewhere.
Perhaps you had.
Hey, the man inside talking to Miss Constantine. Give him this note and forget where you got it. Understand?
Something unexpected has come up. I'll contact you later.
Just a moment, friend. I want to work at
you. Oh, hey! Hey, you guys, come on, get out of here! What's going on?
Oh, Sergeant Preston, thank goodness. Come quickly.
What's the trouble, Miss Constantine?
There's a fight inside.
very serious. How'd the fight start?
Well, I was talking to a Mr. Talon, and he excused himself and got up. Then there was a man who was sitting over at that table. He got up, too, and tried to stop Mr. Talon. Well, there was a struggle, and Mr. Talon shoved the man into the table, and they start to fight.
What happened to Talon?
He went out the back way with the other man following him.
This other man, did you know him?
No, I never saw him before in my life.
Then suppose you tell me what you do know about Talon.
Well, I met him this morning.
We'll be safe here.
No one uses this cabin. Tell me, who are you? Why'd you send me that warning note and then lead me here?
I'm a businessman, Mr. Talon. I'll come right to the point. The law is after you. Police know you're in Whitehorse. I'm here to get you away with a whole skin. For a price.
Oh. And that price is?
The Eye of Evil.
The Black Pearl? Why, your joke. You're joking. That's worth a king's ransom.
Or a thief's. Exactly, Mr. Talon.
No, that's impossible. Of course, I'm willing to bargain.
It's now 11:55 to 12. You have until midnight to make up your mind, my friend. Now, do I get the pearl? Or, do I take it?
There's no doubt that Talon meant to sell you the pearl and then disappear. Either he recognized the stranger behind him as an enemy, or he learned somehow that we were after him.
Well, I was certain he wasn't what he claimed to be the minute we began talking, Sergeant.
You're sure that this is Talon's hat?
Oh, yes.
Then he won't get far. Once King picks up the scent, well, we'll catch up to him quickly. You're going back to the mansion, aren't you?
As soon as Martin returns for me.
Oh, yes, Martin. Well, good night, Miss Constantine.
Good night, Sergeant. You and King must come out to see us very soon.
We will. Come on, King.
Don't be a fool. Kill me and you will hang for your crime.
Time's run out, Talon. I want that pearl, and I want it now.
I don't have it on me, I tell you. Now, look, be sensible. Let me sell it, and we'll divide the money.
Give me that pearl, Talon.
I don't have it, I tell you! I won't tell you! No! I don't...
Picked up the scent, old fella?
Come on, let's go.
Okay, pal, get your hands in the air.
Who are you?
Never mind. Just keep your hands in the air. Now move.
Look, pal, you got me all wrong.
On the double, King. Come on.
Oh,
jump to conclusions, Sergeant.
All right.
A permit for that gun, in case you're wondering.
Did you have a permit to kill this man?
Now, just a minute.
What happened to the contents of this pouch?
Suppose you tell me. Well, I guess this is a murder hazard. I found a pouch in the body, empty.
We'll make sure that you don't have the contents when we get back to the station.
So you're going to take me in?
There's been a shell fired from this gun. Whom were you shooting at just now?
At the murderer, whoever he is.
Can you describe the man that you claim killed Tullen?
No, I can't. He was dark and he had his back to me. He was big, that's all I know.
Are you sure that's all? You're in a tight spot, you know.
How well I know. I think I winged him in the arm. That's it. Anything else?
Yes. One important thing. Who are you?
I was wondering when you'd get around to that.
Well?
Name, Gerald Traynor. Jerry for short. Age, 27. Nationality, American. Residence, San Francisco. Occupation, operative for the Pinkerton Detective Agency. Present assignment, recovery for a client who should remain anonymous. One Black Pearl. Known as the Eye of Evil. And whoever named that gem sure said a mouthful. You'll find my credentials in my inside pocket. Anything else?
Not at the moment. Of course, I'll verify all this.
Naturally. You still going to take me in?
Certainly.
I have the habit of asking foolish questions. What about Tollin's murder? He's a dangerous man. I have an idea that he'd just as soon kill you as anybody. Still going after him?
I am. If such a man exists, we'll get him. It happens to be a habit of the mounted police. Let's go. Come on, King.
A telegram from Dawson next morning confirmed Jerry Traynor's story. And a message had been received from the Pinkerton office in San Francisco asking for official cooperation in apprehending Tallon, the jewel thief, and the recovery of the Eye of Evil Pearl. It had been necessary for Preston to hold Traynor until verification was received.
Well, Sergeant, what's the birdie? I find your little nest here quite cozy. Thoughts a bit too confining for one of my temperament.
Well, get your belongings and come on out. I'm going to release you, Traynor. Your position in this case has been officially verified. Your office in San Francisco has requested our cooperation. Cooperation works both ways, Traynor.
It's the best news I've heard since Dewey took Manila. May I have my credentials back now?
Yes, you may. But before you leave, I'd like to ask you one more question.
I might have known there'd be a catch to it. Okay, Sergeant. Give it to me gently.
Sit down, Traynor.
This isn't my morning to argue, Sergeant.
Did Tullen recognize you in the cafe last night? What I mean is, did he try to escape because he knew you were a detective, here to recover the pearl?
I'm sure he didn't know me from Adam. He was already a badly frightened man before I tried to prevent him from leaving the cafe.
And the reason that he suddenly became frightened is probably the clue to his murder.
I can't tell you why, Sergeant, but I can tell you what did it.
What?
Well, before he jumped up, he read a note under the table. I couldn't see where it came from. And it wasn't on his body when I found him later, dead.
Well, I'll keep in touch.
Traynor?
Yeah?
Oh, never mind.
Preston had no legal reason to hold Traynor and decided that the detective might be of more help to him if he were free. The real problem was, what was in that note to make a confident man like Tallon run for cover? The missing note must be found. Preston decided to start looking for it in the abandoned cabin where Tallon was murdered.
Come on, King. We're going on a paper hunt.
Traynor impatiently waited for the night waiter to come on duty at the cafe. While at the Constantine mansion a few miles from town...
Come in. It's you, Mrs. Carr. Where's Luann?
Still abed. And no wonder after such goings-on last night.
Well, what is it? I got work to do.
It's last night's business I want to know about. How did you hurt your arm?
told you, I caught her on some barbed wire at the store.
That might pass for the truth with the girl, but it doesn't with me. You're forgetting that I doctored it for you, and I know a bullet wound when I see one.
All right. So you heard Mr. Constantine and Luann talking about the Eye of Evil, pearl worth a fortune. Well, I've got it now. I had a little trouble getting it.
You're liable to have a little more trouble keeping it, unless you make it worth my while to help you.
Harpy!
Don't you dare talk to me like that. You keep your voice down and your hands to yourself. You're in enough hot water already.
You're not getting any more out of me through paying your blood money. Finish, do you understand?
You've got that pearl, Mr. Embezzler, and I want my share. Same as I've been getting from what you've been stealing from Mr. Constantine all these years.
Well, you're not getting any more, understand?
Planning to light out without giving me my share, are you?
Don't be ridiculous.
You can't bluff me. I saw your bags all packed under your bed this morning. How far do you think you'd get if I told Sergeant Preston what I know?
All right. You win. What's your proposition?
Half of everything. 50-50. And I'm going right along with you to make sure I get it.
What about the girl, Luann? She'll suspect something if we leave together.
You leave that little snip to me. I'll take care of her proper.
Remember me?
Oh, sure. You're the fellow that started the trouble last night.
Oh, no, not me. You're responsible.
Me? What do you mean, me?
A bit of paper started that shindig. The bit of paper you gave that man that I tried to stop last night. The man with the beard.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Maybe this will help.
Oh, yeah, I think I remember. You mean the note I gave to the man with the beard that was talking to Miss Constantine?
Suppose you tell me what it said.
I don't know. I didn't read it. Honest.
Okay. We'll forget that for the moment. Who gave it to you and where?
Well, I was out and back dumping some garbage, and this fella came along and...
What was his name?
Well, it was pretty dark and cold, and he was all covered up. I didn't see his face.
But you do remember who he was?
No.
Come on, now. You don't want to get involved in a murder.
A murder? I should say not. It was Mr. Martin. You know, the fellow that works for Mr. Constantine, that lives in a big mansion.
Okay. How do I get there?
Well, you go north on a river road for about 4 miles. You can't miss it.
We're going to hire a dog sled.
Well, see Jim Jordan. He'll probably let you have a team. His shack is right next to the general store.
Here, buy yourself a cigar.
Are you in there?
Well, looks like I play this solo.
We might as well give up, King. I searched every inch of this cabin and the ground around it. No trace. Did you smell out something I missed? The wind must have blown this under here. That's what it is. This is what I want. Good boy, King. Only one man that could have written this, King. Martin. He's the only one that knew I was after Tallon. Come on, we'll go back to the station and get our sled.
Faster, Husky!
Someone's coming.
Faster!
Trainer! Over here!
Oh, there!
Trainer, I've no time to waste. One of our other dogs.
Oh!
Martin?
That's right. How'd you know?
I bought the information from a waiter at the cafe.
Well, we've no time to lose. If Martin should decide to clear out...
You lose a murder, and I lose the Eye of Evil.
That's right.
Sergeant, at your service.
Hey!
Everything's packed and ready on the sled out back. Where's Luann?
Locked in her room. you hadn't talked loud enough for her to eavesdrop, we'd have been
on
our...
It's too late to worry about her now. I told you to get rid of her.
I'll have no blood on my hands, Martin.
Well, I can't afford to be so squeamish anymore.
Just a minute. Luann has done nothing to harm either of us.
Well, you surprise me, Mrs. Carp. I didn't think you had a heart.
Don't be ridiculous. I've just too much respect for the hangman's noose.
Very well, then. We'll find some other way to dispose of Miss Constantine. Bring her down.
You'll never get away with this.
How nice of you to be so concerned over your faithful employees. Turn your back to Mrs. Carp and put your hands behind you. I'm handicapped with one bad arm. Give me that gun. I'll hold it on her while you tie her up hands and feet. Well, come on, come on. I told you I wouldn't kill her. Got no time to waste, woman.
If we're taking the girl with us, we'll have to hide her.
Now it's your turn, Mrs. Carr. Get in the closet.
You tricked me.
So I have. Now do as I say. I'm a desperate man, Mrs. Carr. And don't forget, I can only hang once.
I'll get even with you, Martin, if it takes to my dying day.
Then I advise you to work fast, Mrs. Carr. You haven't got much time left.
A gun to be effective at this range.
What do we do?
Well, we'll split up. I'll cover you while you and King run to the back. You get back there, attract his attention. I'll have to make this quick. There's no telling what's happened to those women inside. Aren't you ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
All right, go.
Come on, King.
Stay where you are, Martin. I'm arresting you in the name of the Crown.
If I die, I take you with me.
Pick up that gun, Sheriff. Come on your feet, Martin. Come on. I'm holding you for murder. Sit down over there.
Well, Sergeant, you got your man. What about my pearl?
Well, Martin was running away. Probably has it on him.
It's taped under the bandage. Let me out. I'll gladly give evidence against him.
After several days of questioning Martin and Mrs. Carp, Preston had gathered enough evidence to provide the Crown with an airtight case against them. The lawman's thorough handling of all details left Trainer free to spend a great deal of time with Lou Ann, who was delighted by her new companion.
The Eye of Evil. Certainly well named, eh, Sergeant?
Yes, it is.
I guess that wraps it up. Mrs. Carton hands the postmaster's wife. And Martin being held here for a trial.
Well, with Mrs. Carp turning Queen's evidence, that's all I needed. I suppose you'll be glad to take the pearl back and get out of this icebox, as you call it.
Well, not exactly. I wired the office in Frisco to send up another man to pick up this bauble. I'm no longer a Pinkerton man. I resign.
Does that mean you're staying on?
Well, Mr. Trainer seems to have fallen in love with our country, Sergeant.
Well... Are you sure that's the only attraction? You know the way I figure it, King. This case is closed.